What's going on, y'all? So the college football season is less than a month away, and I thought it'd be fun to do a little season prediction video. Now, I've seen a bunch of these done for all the big schools out there, the Alabamas and the Ohio States of the world, but I've yet to see one done on the school closest to me. I live in St. Petersburg, Florida, which is just across the bay from Tampa, home to the University of South Florida. Now, if you don't know much about the Bulls, here's a quick little recap. They fired their previous head coach, Jeff Scott, after he led them to just 4 wins in 3 years.
Not great, Bob.
And now they have a new head coach, Alex Golesh, who previously served as the offensive coordinator at Tennessee under Josh Heupel. I really like this hire for USF. I think Golesh will get the Bulls back on track, but I think it's going to take a little bit of time, and I think this year one is going to be pretty rough.
Yeah, take it away, Ernie. It's going to be a bumpy ride.
All right, let's get into the schedule. So week one, USF is on the road. They got a tough one. They're at Western Kentucky. Western Kentucky is going to be one of the better G5 programs out there. They got a really good quarterback by the name of Austin Reed. Really cool story for this kid. Originally from St. Augustine, started at Southern Illinois, redshirted, then transferred to D2 West Florida, where he led them to a natty. Then he transferred to Western Kentucky last year, and he balled out. Put up like 5,000 passing yards, like 40 touchdowns. This kid can sling it.
Reed will throw to the end zone. It's caught, and it's a touchdown!
Also doesn't hurt that Reed has an incredible receiver to throw to in Malachi Corley. This kid is electric. He's about 5'11", 200 pounds, huge numbers last year. 101 catches for nearly 1,300 yards and 11 touchdown receptions. A lot of people think he's going to go in the early rounds of next year's NFL draft. So, yeah, the Hilltoppers have a pretty scary duo in Austin Reed and Malachi Corley. This is a tough matchup for the Bulls. I think, and Vegas agrees with me, they're probably going to lose by a touchdown or more. They're 13.5-point underdogs in this one. Unfortunately for the Bulls, I think they start the Golesh era with an L.
You get nothing. You lose. Good day, sir.
All right, week two, the Bulls return home to take on the Rattlers of Florida A&M in their home opener. Now, if you're just a casual college football fan, you probably look at this game and think, easy dub for USF, right? FBS versus FCS.
Not so fast, my friends.
FAMU is one of the better FCS programs out there. They got a great head coach in Willie Simmons. I actually got a chance to cover him when he was up in Tallahassee. He's done a phenomenal job in turning around that program. And the Rattlers are expected to be pretty good this year. They're picked to win the SWAC. They got a lot of players on offense and defense that are preseason all SWAC guys. This might be a closer game than USF fans will hope for, but I still think the Bulls have the edge in talent. And the fact that the game is also in Tampa, I think USF wins that one and gets their first dub in the Alex Golesh era.
Thank you, God.
Victory!
All right, so USF is 1-1 heading into their big week 3 matchup against Nick Saban and the Alabama Crimson Tide. Look, I'm not going to spend too much time on this one. It's Alabama. It's South Florida. Even with the Tide having questions at quarterback, I don't think this game's going to be close. The spread's probably going to be something like 20 or 30 points. If USF can somehow keep this like within a 21-point margin, build the Golesh statue now because I will be thoroughly impressed. But yeah, I think USF loses that game by a lot and falls to 1-2.
Well, this stinks.
So the Bulls go 1-2 against their non-conference opponents. Week 4, it's time for some AAC action. USF will open up conference play against a new member of the American, the Owls of Rice University. So Rice went 5-8 last year, not too great, but I will say this, if you look at their year-by-year record, they have been getting progressively better under head coach Mike Bloomgren. They do have a new starting quarterback in JT Daniels, a name that if you follow college football, you're probably pretty familiar with. He's kind of bounced around all over the country. I think he started at USC, then went to Georgia, recently went to West Virginia, and now he's at Rice. So 4 schools in about 5 or 6 years. They also have another kid that you might have heard of, Luke McCaffrey, the younger brother of star running back Christian McCaffrey. I had no idea, but apparently he switched positions. I remember him originally being a quarterback when he was at Nebraska, ended up transferring to Rice. I think he still tried to play quarterback, but then eventually, you know, decided to play receiver. And he was actually pretty decent last year. Put up like 700 yards, 6 touchdowns. Curious to see what he looks like in 2023 with a new quarterback. Truthfully, I think this game against Rice will determine what kind of team USF has going forward because this is a winnable game for the Bulls. In my opinion, I think they have more talent than Rice does. The game is in Tampa. I don't know what the spread's going to be. I don't know who's going to be favored. My guess is South Florida will be favored. But either way, I'm taking the Bulls in this one. I think they beat Rice and improve to 2-2.
Winner, winner, chicken dinner.
Next up for the Bulls, they'll head to Annapolis, Maryland to take on Navy.
Not the Navy!
Navy also has a new head coach, Brian Newberry. He was previously their defensive coordinator. They went ahead and promoted him. Navy had a pretty good defense last year. They returned quite a bit of production from that side of the ball, so I imagine they're still going to be pretty good on defense. Offensively, we know what Navy is. They're going to run triple option until you want to pull your hair out.
I can't take it anymore! I just want to die! We all want to die!
Anywho, this is a game that I think USF probably loses, and the main reason I'm saying that is because I just don't trust them on the road. You haven't won a road game since before the pandemic, 2019 to be exact. So, yeah, I'm sorry, Bulls fans, but I'm taking South Florida to drop that one against Navy.
My disappointment is immeasurable, and my day is ruined.
All right, so after that, USF has another road game. This time, they're taking on the Fightin' Trent Dilfers of UAB. Yes, in case you didn't know, Trent Dilfer, the former Super Bowl-winning quarterback and ESPN analyst, is now the head coach at UAB. And before I even get into the prediction, I want to share my favorite Trent Dilfer clip of all time.
You cannot lose games in the NFL and still win. So if New England can just...
Brilliant analysis as always, Trent. Good stuff. Seriously, though, I have no idea how this experiment is going to work. It's a pretty out-of-the-box hire for the Blazers. Trent Dilfer has no experience coaching at the collegiate level. He coached in high school. That's about it. But who knows? Maybe it'll work. Maybe I'll be totally wrong. So UAB went 7-6 last year, won their bowl game. I believe it was the Bahamas Bowl, if I'm not mistaken. They do return their quarterback, Jacob Zeno, who was okay. He didn't light up the world by any means. The Blazers have typically had a really good running game, but I am curious to see if it'll be as potent this season because they lost their leading rusher from last season and they lost a number of starters along the offensive line. That being said, they do bring back Jermaine Brown, who was second-team All-Conference USA last year and put up nearly 1,000 rushing yards. Last season, the Blazers were pretty good defensively, but they did lose a number of key players to the portal, so I imagine they'd probably take a slight step back this year, at least on that side of the ball. So, yeah, the fact that UAB is a pretty solid team and the fact that, once again, it's on the road, I'm going to have to say the Bulls will drop this one. And so halfway through the season, I have USF sitting at 2-4.
God damn it!
Gosh darn it!
Shit!
Shoot!
The Bulls will kick off the second half of their season at home against another new member of the American, FAU. Now, the Owls also have a new head coach, Tom Herman, former head coach at Houston and Texas. FAU went 5-7 a year ago, but I think they're going to do even better this year, despite the fact that they're going into a tougher conference. I really like some of the weapons they have. You know, it all starts with quarterback Casey Thompson, a one-time Texas quarterback, most recently played at Nebraska. They also got a really talented running back in Larry McCam III. He was first-team All-Conference USA a year ago. And the wide receiver, LaJonte Wester, super talented as well. Defensively, FAU wasn't great last year, but they weren't terrible either. They finished top four in Conference USA in points allowed. However, they did finish in the bottom five of the conference in yards allowed. They gave up almost 430 yards a game. That being said, they should be a little better this year. They return 8 of their top 11 tacklers, including 2 all-conference guys in Evan Anderson and Armani Eli Adams. So with all that being said, even though this game is in Tampa, I think the Owls get the best of the Bulls in this matchup, and USF falls to 2-5 on the year. All right, so after that, USF is on the road. They will head to Storrs, Connecticut to take on the Huskies of UConn. I don't know if there was a better coaching job last season than Jim Moore. I mean, that program was an absolute dumpster fire for years before he got there. And in his very first season, he got into a bowl game. This ain't UConn from a couple years ago. They are actually going to be a pretty solid team this year like they were last season. And I imagine they'll probably make another bowl game. They bring back Taquan Roberson, the Penn State transfer, who was supposed to be their starting quarterback last season, but he got hurt in week one and didn't play the rest of the year. They also bring back 4 starting offensive linemen from last year's team, and they bring back 8 starters on defense. And so with that, I have the Bulls dropping another one and falling to 2-6.
Come on now, dawg. Come on, man.
All right, so after that UConn game, USF has a bye week, and then after the bye week, they hit the road again and play at Memphis. The Tigers have had a pretty good program for a couple years now. I mean, they haven't had a losing season since 2013. Obviously, they were really, really good when Mike Norvell was the head coach, who's now at Florida State, but they've been solid as well under Ryan Silverfield, who's now entering his fourth year at the helm. Tigers went 7-6 last year, won their bowl game against Utah State. I imagine that's probably where they'll finish around this season, maybe a little bit better. They were picked to finish fourth in the conference. They got a really good quarterback in Seth Hennigan, a veteran starter, threw for 22 touchdowns and 8 picks a year ago. They returned 3 of their starting offensive linemen. Defensively, Memphis was okay last year. They were 5th in the conference in scoring defense. This is going to be a pretty big challenge for USF. Like I said, any game on the road for them this year will be, but especially against a team that is as talented as Memphis. And so I have the Bulls dropping this one as well and falling to 2-7.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
Next up for the Bulls, they got a home game against the Temple Owls. Now, USF played Temple last year up in Philly, and I feel confident in saying that was the absolute lowest point of the Jeff Scott era. So much so that it got him fired. And understandably so, because a terrible Temple team hung up 54 points on USF and put up 621 yards of offense. Now, I imagine this year's Temple team will be a little bit better than last year's squad that went 3-9. They bring back their starting quarterback, EJ Warner, the son of former NFL star Kurt Warner. He had some really nice moments as a true freshman last year, but he also had some moments where he looked like a true freshman. If he can take that next step in his development, and if he can get some help in terms of maybe the run game getting going, or maybe another wide receiver stepping up, and if the defense can take another step forward, specifically when it comes to creating turnovers, I think the Owls could win a few more games this year. But I do not have one of those wins coming against South Florida. I think the Bulls pull off an upset here, if you want to call it an upset, and get some revenge on the Owls and get a win at home to improve to 3-7 on the year.
We did it! We did it! We did it! Yay!
Shall we see, Ma?
We did it!
All right, so after that, the Bulls will hit the road for one final time this regular season as they head to San Antonio to take on the UTSA Roadrunners.
Meep, meep.
Meep, meep.
So, minus, obviously, Alabama, this is going to be the toughest game of the year for the Bulls. UTSA has been the darling of the Group of Five for the past couple years now. They've won back-to-back Conference USA championships, and they're expected to compete with Tulane to win the American Conference Championship this season. They bring back a veteran quarterback in Frank Harris. Their offense, I believe, was like top 15 in the country last year. Maybe if this game was in Tampa, I'd be a little more inclined to maybe pick USF as a big upset here. But the fact that it's in Texas, yeah, there's no way. I think the Bulls are going to lose this game, and they're going to lose probably by double digits, most likely. And so they will fall to 3-8 on the year.
Damn, 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 damn.
Last but not least, USF will wrap up its regular season schedule at home against another new member of the American, UNC Charlotte. Charlotte is the one team that was picked to finish behind South Florida in the American. They were picked to finish dead last in the conference. And their new head coach did not take too kindly to that.
Any other questions for Coach?
That's it? 3 questions? Maybe that's because you have us ranked last. That's all what you think of us. So we get that message. Thank you.
For real though, Charlotte got absolutely ravaged by the portal. They lost a lot of talent, and they also went 3-9 last year, so they didn't really have a ton of talent to begin with. So yeah, I feel like they're probably going to end up finishing dead last in the conference as well, which means I got USF beating them in their regular season finale and finishing the year at 4-8. Well, that was fun. Hey, listen, if you like the video, be sure to like and subscribe to my channel. And just a heads up, I'm going to keep producing content like this throughout the year. And not just college football. I want to do stuff on the NFL, the NBA, MLB, you name it. Have a good one.